Next theorem. One point 1 8. Let F maps A to B be a function. Then F is a bijection if and only if there exists a function G maps B to A such that F circle G equal to IB and G circle F is equal to IA and in this case G is equal to F inverse. So now we have to prove that G is equal to F inverse providing these two conditions. So let us prove. F maps A to B be a function. So that implies F inverse B to A is a bijection or function as well as bijection is given. Bijection. So now G maps B to A is a function. This is given in the problem. So F inverse and G are defined on same domain B. Now consider F of A is equal to B. That implies F inverse B is equal to A. So now F inverse B is equal to A. This we can write IA of A. So therefore IA given that G circle F. This is G circle F of A. This is G of F of A. f of a is equal to b, that is g of b. But g is a function from b to a, so g of b is also here a, or g of b, that's an f. So that means f inverse b equal to g of b. So both f inverse and g are defined on the same domain and they have the same range. Hence g is equal to f inverse. Next theorem, 1.2.19 theorem. Let f maps a to b, g maps b to c, and h maps c to d, then h circle of g circle f equals to h circle g of circle f. Proof. Since f maps a to b, g maps b to c, and h maps c to d, so g circle f, that implies g circle f maps a to c and h maps c to d. Therefore, that implies now h circle of g circle f is from a to d. Since f maps a to b, g maps b to c, and h maps c to d. So f maps a to b, that implies, and h circle g maps from b to d. So that implies s circle g of circle f is maps from a to d. If you observe these two relations, a same domain, d same codomain, these two functions have the same domain and same codomain, or these two functions are defined on same domain with same codomain. Now consider a belongs to a, that implies h circle of g circle f of a, this we can write h of g circle f of a. This can be written h of g of f of a. Now rearrange the brackets, this is h circle g of f of a. Again this can be written h circle g of circle f of a. So therefore h circle of g circle f equals to s circle g of circle f.